Good evening, everybody. Back on again, and this time around, it's going to be Divinity Original Sin 2. Possibly over the weekend, excuse me. And I had one of those weird sleeps today. Got a good 6 or 7 hours, but apparently it wasn't enough because I'm feeling like crap right now. So there's going to be a chance that this might be a shorter than normal stream. By the latter part of the stream, I'm probably going to be. But we'll see when it happens. Okay, this is also going to be another one of my rare times where I actually pretty much set everything up first. And then started the stream. I guess I'm not completely done. Let me set my fan on the floor there. I'm going to be playing this game with a controller, and I like to have the controller down on the floor. So having the fan down there helps keep my hands cool and dry. Otherwise, they just get all sweaty and sticky. Oh, and I'm going to have me a protein shake. Since I've been off lifting weights recently, and I'm gonna have me some grapes. So let me test out this Twitch app. Make sure it's working. Yep, app works. It's a big old tentacle. I'm gonna try something. I was gonna try running under the tentacle when it was up in the air. Yippers! Actually, there's a bit of a drawback with this game. you can either play with a controller or a mouse and keyboard, but you can't play with both. Yep. It's blue. Oh, hi, mine. Way better than pink, that's for sure.
You see those tentacles, kid? It's time to get the hell out of here.
Thank you! There's a ladder right over there. You can go straight down.
You're gonna be the death of us, you hear?
Raw lumpy giblets. Waiting for them. Yeah, unfortunately it wasn't on sale when I got it. I think it was like 40 or 50 bucks or something like that. Mere worm.
They smell even worse dead than alive. Let's head above decks for some air.
I don't know. This is my first time being in this area. Last time I played this, I just jumped off the ship. I thought everybody on here was already dead. Apparently not. Yeah, he's cooked and fried.
Sounds like she needs help.
She tries to speak, but can only gape as she clutches her neck, trying to stem the bleeding of a gushing wound. With jagged movements, she raises her clenched fist and holds out a length of cloth, soaked with some kind of strong-smelling tincture. Blood quickly soaks through the cloth. Magister C1's mouth opens and closes, her eyes wide in terror.
I don't want a strangulator.
It's working. The pressure is stemming the flow of blood. C1 clutches your arm, her eyes locked with yours. Something within the ship snaps. The floorboards shudder. C1 struggles to her feet, clinging to you tightly. The ship lets out a deep groan.
It is not yet your time, my son.
Honorable Dallas, we lost a ship sailing sorcerer prisoners to Fort Joy. We assume some escaped and broke their collars. Their vile magic lured the Voidwook. All who were aboard are presumed dead.
Nope.
Yours faithfully into eternity, High Judge Orivan.
Short bloody work of the ship. Am I the lone survivor? It seems someone, something, wanted me alive. I thought the Order would get rid of any trace of the old Source King.
Well, apparently not, buddy. Okay, I'm gonna read through my journal. Where the weather was not quite so merry. Excuse me. go cracking. Now I gotta try and remember how I did this. I'm gonna make this area my stash. Gotta remember how I did it. I think it was holding hand. Yeah, there we go. Gonna get kind of tedious, though. Huh, my first bow. What, wrong one. Probably gonna leave those out, that one too. Huh? Yeah, she's got a dragon fetish. You can't put stuff in that one. It's almost full. Two more. Might want to hold on to that. I gotta figure out how to set it down. So putting a crate inside of a vase? Is that even possible? You would think that since I have vase opened up, empty hand would mean put the stuff into it, but apparently not. Let me quick save this first. Okay, so all my stuff's still in it then. Well, like I said, this area here is gonna be my stash.
Child has a small mirror in his hands. He holds it up at angles, inspecting his eyes, his chin, the crown of his head. He spots you, and his arms snap to his sides.
I'm not supposed to talk to strangers. Why? But are you a sorcerer? One of those guys that brings the bad void things here?
The child looks at you straight on, unafraid, searching your face. He lifts his mirror to his nose, closes one eye, and looks at himself again.
I don't see any source on you or me. I guess they're wrong or crazy. No one cares where I go. They know I can't leave the island. It's nicer out here than inside anyway. They're gone now. The magisters took them already. Guess now they're cured? And maybe they're waiting for me back at home. But you didn't die. Guess I am, but it's just normal to be scared. Nowhere isn't scary. There isn't anywhere safer. That's what I mean. You'll see.
Bridge out. Hey, the short end of the stick. Monsters are up ahead.
Boy Woken, those are the same beasts that sank our ship. Damn, they made it ashore.
So, now that I got an area that's basically infinite inventory space, or basically an infinite stash, I can pretty much pick up everything.
Cat's eyes are clouded and grey, but it stares at you with acute intensity. Its eyes clear, and it shakes its head, confused.
Uh-oh. Something's about to happen. Cool. picking up all the shells. And then there are different kinds too. Meow. So I need to get a boiling pot then.
You spot a strange lizard gazing over the water with a steady, malcontent stare. His skin is of a bright, blood-red color. Could he be... Yes, you recognize him from the ship. It would seem you're not the only one who survived the tentacles of the deep. The lizard turns about with the graceful ease of a dancer, or a duelist. You lock eyes with his, two smoldering embers that sizzle your very soul.
With a bucket on my head? Yeah.
I did survive, yes. And chances are I wouldn't have, had you not returned to the aid of your fellow passengers down in that dreadful hole. You have my gratitude.
Hand over heart, he salutes you with a bob of the head. More than a nod, though less than a bow.
Yes, I'm sure you've all the makings of a hero and all that, but let's not get carried away, shall we?
I'll try some. Oh, yeah, that's right. I can't use a mouse.
Now then, if there's nothing further. If you really must know, I haven't quite decided yet. I've a frightful amount of things on my mind, hence my standing here contemplating the waves.
He sighs dramatically.
Tell me, what do you see when you cast your glance over this ocean? Memories. Quite so.
He looks out over the water once more, and so do you. A few tranquil moments pass as the waves lap against your thoughts.
As for myself, when I consider this vast expanse before us, I see an empire. I see continents dotted with mighty cities. And shimmering along the soft curve of the sea's horizon, I picture the palaces that formed my paradise. Lost. What do you mean, what do I mean? I mean just what I say. I had a very actual empire that I lost.
Suddenly, having all the air of being deeply offended, he stares at you with utter incredulity.
Yep, because the only reason I said that was just to piss him off.
Well, don't just stand there gawking like an ape at an abacus. Or do you really mean to tell me you don't know who I am? Damn pity, isn't it? For I am the Red Prince, the All-Conqueror, the World Tamer, the Spouse of the Sun. Of course you know me.
There's a brief moment's pause, during which his grandiloquent pose deflates ever so slightly.
That said, I suppose I must own up to the fact that I find myself rather in between all-conquering and world-taming opportunities at the moment. Grandeur that is my fate has hit a bit of a snap. But never you worry. For the throne I was destined, and my throne I shall have.
this. Excuse me.
Truly. A kind offer indeed. And you've already proven to be trustworthy enough. You came back for the others on that ship, after all. Fine. I accept. On one condition. For reasons I'll not disclose right now, it is imperative that I should meet with a dreamer, one of the mystics of my kind. I've reason to believe one of them may be present on this island. Promise me we'll look for him, and I'll extend you the blessing of my company. Jolly good. So, now that that's settled, first things first. Even if you are as versed in the art of eloquence as I am, that our swords will be doing a lot of the talking from here on out goes without saying. As a born fighter, I prefer the perfection of the blade myself. But I'm well acquainted with the secrets of magic, and yes, even subterfuge. What say you?
Yeah, I'm probably gonna make him a tank. Let me go in the browser real quick and look up the classes. Not sure what that is. Little muscle. Fighter.
Very well. Onwards then to victory or death.
The Red Prince nods and gives you a smile that wavers ever so delicately between courtesy and contempt.
Now, as you're aware, you'll be traveling with a prince. Proper forms of address include Your Majesty, Your Royal Highness, or if you're feeling particularly frivolous, Milord.
Or I could just simply call him Red.
As your luck. I seem to be fresh out of luggage, so you won't be required to carry my belongings. Of course, there are other forms of protocol to bear in mind, but I'll see to it and pick up the rest as we go. So, without...
on a stick. Oh, okay. Already has one. Says there's like a portal or something over here, according to the map. Looks like a lot of trouble to get to. And I think there was a map option. That allowed you to keep the north arrow in the top part of the map and not constantly moving around. Alright, there we go. Much better. Check this area out real quick. Oh, looks like I can't get to it. Oh, this is, already talked to her.
I've spotted something. I need a shovel.
Let me, There we go.
Wonder where this leads.
As the alcove opens up, you see the same skeleton that you met on the boat before it sank. He's still not wearing his mask. He's leaning over a corpse, prodding and pulling at the skin of his face. Bugger.
How on earth am I supposed to...
Skeletal fingers reach down and grip the skin of the dead man's face, pulling sharply upwards. After a few more tugs at the man's cheeks, the skeleton relents, letting the head drop to the ground with a damp thud.
Damnation. That stuck fast. I wonder, does the beard act as some form of anchor? Ah! No! Stay back! Don't... Oh, it's you. I must admit I'm surprised. Perhaps you're more buoyant than I suspected. It seems the human that stole my mask was rather more resourceful than I gave her credit for. I chased her here, but she rather seems to have given me the slip. Thus...
He turns back to the body, prodding at its face cautiously.
Why, its face, of course. What other use would I have for some rotting corpse? A face that seems rather stubbornly attached to his skull.
Huh. Gonna wear a skin as a funny hat.
I would normally employ a tool to delicately but viciously rip the face from the body. I could then craft a mask to hide my bone. But as I lack such a tool...
The skeleton grabs the corpse by the cheeks and pulls hard, grunting in frustration as the body's skin holds firm.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. I have important things to do on Reaper's Coast. I cannot simply sit about waiting for the rest of you to die so I may continue my business in peace. No, I may be an eternal, but my patience has its limits. Indeed, I may be the only eternal. My people seem rather absent.
I still wish they would say something like, telepathically, he says all this to you. Otherwise, I mean... Structurally, it's really not possible for him to talk like this. I mean, you know, no larynx, no voice box, no jaw muscle or anything like that, no tongue. That's about the most you get out of him.
At least from this realm. As for the others, well, there is an excavation site at the Black Pits oil field. Perhaps there I'll find my answers. A cult? Hardly. We were a race that existed before the idea of race was needed. We were all one. I could ask you to imagine an Eternal as a creature of incredible intelligence and skill. But I fear the limits of your imagination would not do us justice. We studied the mysteries of the universe. We created works of great art. We disappear. But I will find them. Wherever they are, I will find them. We will have our world again. Well, that hardly seems relevant. But if you must know, I was inconvenienced for a time. Several centuries, in fact, or perhaps millennia, one tends to lose track. I was sealed in a tomb for daring to be curious about the world. It seems our king did not agree that the universe should be explored to its full potential.
Bit of an isolationist, huh?
Perhaps I should thank him. It seems I was spared whatever happened to the others. I wonder if flowers would be appropriate. Ah, well, Well, that is the curious thing. They are clearly absent from this world, and yet they are everywhere. Every one of your races resembles them in some manner. And the statues you have built to your gods look remarkably familiar. Perhaps my people have ascended to some new realm. Or perhaps your gods are merely a folk memory. Regardless, they are not here. But I will find them. Wherever they are, I will find them.
Just gonna wish them well
and
leave.
Do feel free to call. By which I mean shout loudly. I do not want you sneaking up on me again.
Whoops. Ooh. There's two more people I need to talk to. Lockpicks! Surely Mr. Eternal there won't mind. Where I gotta be right there. Thank God for bedrolls. Maybe I can walk on that rainbow. Kind of like a rainbow bridge. There's a treasure down there, too. According to the map, it looks like I can travel down there a little more. Okay, so real quick, I'm gonna put my grapes back in the fridge, and then I'm gonna go grab me something to drink. I'll be back in a moment. I'm gonna cook me something to eat as well. And I'm gonna shut my blinds while I'm up. I'm gonna put my fan back on the table. So, down here where I have my controller, it's getting a little too cold. A little bit chilly, so. I'm gonna finish off the rest of my butter beans. And gonna have a couple of V8 energy drinks. But according to the map, it looks like I'd be able to travel a little farther down. Apparently not. So yeah, it looks like there's not really much of a way to get over here.
Stay back, Susan, and stay silent. Our God will be speaks.
We know you've been helping sorcerers escape from the Tusa. We have proof.
I'd sooner cut my tongue out than lie to you, Alexander. I know nothing of any escapees.
Same issue as yesterday. It's like their heads have been cut off. Here, let me, before I continue, let me pull up my paint program. I just made a screenshot of this. Back to the game.
If you can tell the Godwoken no more, your tongue is of no use. Cut it out.
This can't be serious, Alexander. Come.
You should know by now to obey your superior, Magister, whatever she may ask.
Stay silent, you!
Natusa pinches the tip of her tongue with two fingers and brings her dagger to its root. Her eyes squeeze shut. Drops of blood form against the dagger's edge and quickly fall to the ground. She groans.
Stop! My father, may his soul rest in peace, would be dis- disappointed in you, Medusa. To think you would lie to his only son, your bishop, and your friend these many years. The fate of our realm hangs in the balance. If you will not help us save it, then you will help the void destroy it. Dallas?
Yes, your holiness.
I believe we're done here.
Oh, I remember this.
What a waste. Come, we'll be needed elsewhere.
The Lizard Magister, or what's left of her, lies in a puddle of gore.
She was a lizard, yet a magister. No matter her reasons, her penalty was fair.
Huh?
Quite right. Do seek my counsel. I highly recommend. There was a small incident which prompted my many rivals to move against me. Technically, they had the letter of the law on their side. Such a nuisance, the law. Quite necessary to keep the common in line, of course, but one such as myself, it should exempt as
I remember this question yesterday. I'm a lawful person, so I'm going with two. But, only if those laws are just and fair, so... But unfortunately, it doesn't have that as a dialogue option.
By the rabble and for the rabble. You're one of those, aren't you? Remember that by the rabble and for the rabble, sorcerers are being exiled to hell. We'll see if you'll still trumpet the virtues of law when its executors turn to us with malicious intent. I hardly know you as yet. Let's leave some mystery in the relationship, shall we? We can exchange criminal records later. As am I. A prince should die of old age or on the battlefield. Anything else could be construed as weakness of character. That said,
construed.
I had a feeling I wasn't meant to die today. For despite your heroics, I was still cast into the water. I slept. There was something in the water. A voice made of air soothed my flooding.
You too, huh?
There was sudden light, warmth, life. Truly, how intriguing. To hear a voice whilst drowning is a rather specific delusion to share, is it not? Still, I wonder if
he hesitated.
Are you a religious person? I'm rather relieved to hear it. Religious persons tend to be all too self-important, I suppose, too limited. As for myself, I perform the ancient rites of prayer and ceremony with a kind of languid indulgence. After all, when one is revered by many as a living god oneself, public deprecation would be needlessly self-important as well, wouldn't you say?
Apparently I leveled up.
Your grift teaches you to bully others. Pathetic.
You keep his name out of your
mouth. All right.
Have your cards.
He's crust. Just have all the
chocolate. Disgusting like threats.
to go with the strength. Want to be able to carry more. Throwing stuff matters too. Oh, never mind. Thinking of polymorph, but let me do this. Let me quick save. It didn't change. Oh, it did. Okay. So that being said, like I said, mainly the reason I'm increasing strength so I can throw the heavier stuff and so I can carry more.
Business, long pig.
Don't let this moss muncher talk to you like that. Especially a sheep state like this. Griff already knows she don't like to pay her fair share.
And
intense-looking man steps between the thug and the elf and rolls up his sleeves, revealing well-muscled and heavily scarred arms. You recognize him. It's Ifan.
Damn. Guess I was in the right place at the right time.
Just stand aside, won't you, mate? This is no business of yours.
Lone wolves decide their own business.
The thug freezes in fear for a moment before shuffling back to the protection of his crony.
Pay up, elf. No one shorts Griff, especially not one of you. Run for kitchen. Means it runs me, you, and everyone else in town. Everyone in camp's got to contribute. For food, for protection. No exceptions. Especially not for elves.
Food? Protection? I have neither.
You two ought to be thanking your lucky gods it's us, and not the Magisters enforcing around here. A fool never knows what we've got till it's well and gone. Now come on, Elf. If you make me say anything, it's gonna be a trick.
It's gonna get a little messy. But yeah, I'm going with one.
Neither will I.
We got a system, and it looks like you don't want to fit in.
Combat. So she's got magic armor.
Oh, I don't feel so good.
Janie's gonna be next. He's got magic armor too. Her. Hello. She's sleeping. Oh, never mind.
You gonna pray all day, buddy?
Just call it good on you. Okay, so, I think I said this yesterday, but,
oh God, no.
One thing about armor in this game, it's for the most part, it's basically additional hit points, but it also prevents status effects from hitting you. Like, I think knockdown here is a physical status effect. It basically, you lose your turn. But it's resisted by physical armor. What that means is physical armor has to be zero in order for knockdown to even work. Can we target the girl, please? So he should be done.
Hello. You gonna pray all day, buddy?
It shouldn't affect me at all. Bonk. Just gonna end it. That should do it.
Follow me before more of them trouble us.
I've an errand to run around here first. I'll catch up with you there later.
Remember, past the kitchens, down to the beach, inside the caves there. There is a safe place.
Alright, I'm gonna follow her. I'm assuming that's where she's going. I won't remember where this place is otherwise.
fear. Pity, perhaps. A blind wolf may lead the pack, but sooner or later they will all starve. Never mind. If you need to suit up, I can offer you a fair price. If not, I would thank you to...
Okay, I remember this.
No one tells me there are so many children in this Fort Joy. Your kind I handle, but small ones. Children everywhere and an idiot for good measure. The divine truly dies.
The soldier tightens his grip on the spear.
I thought he said he was running a shop. Oh, damn kid turned invisible.
The young girl's eyes are covered, but she turns toward you when you approach. She smiles as though she recognizes
you. Oh, this is like the Oracle chick.
Ah, hello. I see you come a long way. I see you come here seeking a great adventure. Do you find it?
She laughs and looks around as though taking in the scenery, though her eyes are still covered.
Many people to meet, many stones to turn, and there is a great joy here, as though the walls and water themselves were made by many smiling gods. Even if we are here under unhappy circumstances, still I feel it.
I see it before my eyes.
Oh. Upper back is bothering me.
It is not so bad. I know which days have bread and which days have none. I know more bread comes someday. It helps.
Eyebrows shoot up.
There can be a way. Amiro knows. But he is gone. Do you see him? He knows how to leave. My protector, my friend, an elf like me, with a spirit bright as new leaves. He tries to help me, to save me, and he suffers very much. He is caught by those who hurt him. I wish so much for his return. And he tells you what you seek. A way out. You bring me great peace. Thank you, my friend. offends him very much. I see something that helps. I see a lizard. He is a lizard of many dreams, of far feeling. You do not free Amiro without him. Yes, please ask. Oh, I do not cover my eyes. I cover the place they used to be. They are gone now, taken, but I see all the same. He is a very blind man. He sees things, but not truth, not love or joy. I feel very sorry for him. You understand when you meet him, after you escape. It is safer here. We make no trouble for Griff. He makes no trouble for us. I knew we must be here. I am not sure how much to explain. You are here, and so we are here.
I forgot he leveled up too. I wonder if there's a cooldown on that. He's got persuasion. Requires an actual item, huh?
Dog
hey, buddy. Another lockpick. stealing a fishbone. Nobody around. Why would I be stealing it? Stingtail? Who's that? Oh shoot, I still gotta activate the waypoint. There he is. Right now, the first goal is to find the waypoint. Here we go. Yeah, there's gonna be all eyes on this one. Okay, so, yeah, somebody was turning. So the item itself also can't be in the area there. No. Earth one. Looking for all the stolen items? No. Store them away in the crate here. Have anything else stolen here, so let's see what I got. First aid, yeah. Okay, there we go. Uh-oh. Game crash. Okay, maybe not.
Goods. That you wanted.
Give it though, will you?
Perhaps it doesn't really involve the stealing so much.
Yeah, she's got a huntsman items. Something I'm really not looking for.
Blame you with the garbage they got for sale around here. Why don't you take a gander at the goodies I got?
stuff you won't find anywhere else in camp. Procured by special means.
Let's just say folks leave here, but they don't seem to take their effects. Maybe I happen to know where everything ends up.
Only the finest, you know.
There we go. This is the one I need to be pickpocketing from. Of course, I already know all these skills. Yeah. Good luck on being able to steal from her. This place is too well covered. Yeah. Good luck, buddy.
Leave him be. Don't make me say it again.
Listen, I can help you if you just...
Shut up, Elf. This clown, I caught him stealing from my kitchen. Still won't say where he stashed my supplies. Sound like someone you'd let off with a slap on the wrist. Supplies, crate of food, citrus in particular. He'll talk, or he'll die quiet. All I want is my supplies. Happy to let this clown die in a gutter instead of my kitchen. Bring back my crate, and you got yourself a deal. Ain't been here long, have ya? No one gets to have it all. No one starves anyone else.
He twirls his knife between his fingers.
The divine's gone. This blade is the only god watching over Fortune. Listen up. Back off.
Not like this. There's too many of them.
Yeah, and they got eyes on that. Doesn't say. I can't remember if you have to be in sneaking mode or not in order to do this. Here.
Still on your feet, eh? Glad to hear it. Feel free to take it. Fella in that cage is the thief. Stash the oranges somewhere before he was caught. If you believe that. Sure do. Ask me. You'd have to be one of those sad saps that's
in the wrong girl.
She darts her tongue out of her mouth like a snake.
Some folks, and some reptiles, will do anything to get his attention. I see plenty of liars in my line of work. Snakes, weasels, worms. That fella's square as a pavestone. If he's the thief, I'll eat my boots. Sure do. Ask me.
She darts her tongue out of her...
Some folks, I see plenty of liars in my line of work. It's all in the eyes. Joy lives in the eyes. So I'm sure you don't want to have a look at my stock before you go. I'm serious about what I said. Everything in my only the finest, you know.
I'm about to find out if I'll get in trouble for this. This is a stolen item. Dump a bunch of shells on her.
Ain't fit for beasts. Beasts.
All right, equipment. Did it.
Perhaps if those bleeding dwarves didn't mean so much.
Managed to sell off a stolen item. Where's, back when I played Baldur's Gate, if it had the stolen tag on it, no vendor would buy it. You had to actually go to an actual fence in order to sell it off.
Seen one myself, but my cousin up in Gorse and one appeared from the clear sky one day and ate up every child under the age of 12. I don't know where they come from, but without the divine, there ain't much we can do to stop. If Boss trusts you to find something for him, you better not disappoint him. You won't like him when he's disappointed. I mean, that guy in the cave. Don't associate with elves. Fella says he's innocent, but you know how they lie.
Yeah,
bosses are awful passionate about citrus. They can't get enough of the stuff. Boss will be fine. He's got himself in a fit state now, but as soon as another shipment comes in, he'll be right as well.
Guess I don't know if I clicked the right one. Oh, not gonna happen now. Just barely. Armor of Frost. Okay, there we go. Yeah, he ain't got anything. He ain't got anything. Get out. To wait a little. I'm probably gonna have to wait until he actually sits down. Well, sing your song, buddy. Yeah, I'm gonna have to turn him down.
Very worth knowing, but it's hardly a group affair. I only mean one. Oh, noble. But after the magisters take you, all your nobility will have been for nothing. Good luck with your friends, though. Enjoy your last days.
Bye. This guy can't sit still. Other thing I can think of. Struck up a combo with him. Oh. I gotta make sure he's facing the other way, though.
The king's brow knits together, then apart and back again. He seems to be swimming deep in his thoughts and doesn't look up as you approach.
Where's he at? Okay. Yeah, he's still over there. Huh? Nice. Gotta admit, though, it's a pretty good AI. Yeah. This AI is bright enough to notice that its pockets have been picked. I think at Baldur's Gate, you could pretty much steal somebody blind and they wouldn't notice at all. I gotta remember to start stealing better stuff. None the wiser.
Change your mind about my offer.
Oh, so much for that. Oh, that was a quest that doesn't work. Got a lot of herrings. Same thing as before. Use the red press to talk to her.
The woman is scrabbling at her throat, as though she can hardly...
Okay, scratch it.
Don't touch me. You're too close. This collar, this place, it's squeezing the life from me. Do you? You seem fine. Don't you feel how tight this collar is? And there's nothing we can do. Nothing we can do.
Her hands move again to her throat. She seems to try to make space between her neck and the collar, but there's no space to be made.
Yeah, that's what pretty much what I'll be doing most of the time.
Looky here, mates. A fresh face. We love fresh faces, don't we? Oh, yes, we do. Why don't you join us in a round of cards? First hand, chuff to you, Chief. Here are your cards.
You glance at your hand. Two purple monarchs. A hard hand to beat.
Quite the hand, Freshy. Unfortunately, two is less than five, and that's how many purples I've got. I reckon that makes me the winner. I'll be having your fee then. I'm sure the Reds told you. No one gets along without paying the interment fee. So, let's make this easy. Empty your pockets.
Yep. Having a bucket over my head makes me a handsome devil.
About that, Frischie.
23 armor. How? How does that cost 3? I gotta be far enough away. Okay. Probably gonna seem kind of lame, but I sure as hell don't wanna lose hardcore mode in a battle that I wasn't even prepared for. Hell, I wasn't expecting this to be a fight at all, just, you know, doing stuff in town, talking to people, not going into an actual combat, so. past the arena. Magister's key. Okay. Let's all quick save again. Oh, you can't pickpocket more than once. Actually, this might have been a bad idea. I want to wear those boots, but they're actually stolen, so if they're found on me, I'm screwed. Let me save the game. Yeah, and all of these, they're persistent modifications, meaning I can't turn them off. So, kind of risky. So far, I only found one button I can use. Got a few buttons I could use.
I know that look well enough. You're about to pop, ain't ya? Why don't you?
Oh, about to pop, ain't ya?
Some of that frustration out the right way. Can't help you leave, but I do know how you're gonna escape. At least for a few holy minutes. Go on.
Can't go all the way through.
Can we get on with this already?
Can we get on with it already? Okay, so let me try this.
Deep grumble emerges from him, as if from an endless cavern.
Nope, still didn't work.
Who will be next to fight?
Let me quick load this. I don't want to be forced to start the arena. Bit well covered.
Can we get over this already?
Pause. Pause. Bomb grenade. Huh? Orange juice. Said I don't. I kind of want to wear them, but I don't want to get busted with them either. I don't even remember where I got them from. think that's it. And I might be shutting down soon. I'm starting to feel like crap right now. Oh, I know what.
I fear it will be quite some time before we find any answers at all, my friend. Though, it doesn't hurt. Mm-hmm. Goods. Ah, yes. Yes, of course. Have a look.
Yeah, so this guy's a water mage. No point in buying that one. I already have a bunch of them.
Shake me down for my knickers, have you? They're all I got left after you, buddies were through with me. Huh. Right kind of you, my friend. I've grown quite attached to him over the years.
Oh, literally. Hakataro. Yeah, I'm probably gonna do a little bit of running around here. And probably end up shutting down. I had one of those sleeps where I got like a, I think it was like 6 or 7 hours, but it's like it wasn't enough. I ended up waking up feeling like crap. But otherwise, I'm liking this. I actually got the good boat ending. Like, saved everybody on, and unlike last time, I basically just got on a lifeboat and took off and left everybody else to die. Like, whoops. You're almost done, huh?
She seems to fight the smile that appears at the corners of her lips.
Oh, git, will ya?
Classic method. Let me run ahead of her. Come on.
Hey, snake face. What you heard about a crate stolen supplies? And don't you lie to me.
No way, Jose. Too many eyes in this area.
If I did, I wouldn't give him up to you. Griff sent me, not you. Look, I'm Griff's right hand, and I'm gonna find that crook. Still here. Thought you would have gotten cured by now. The Reds.
Damn it.
Heard of anyone that might have taken Griff's supplies yet? Just like everyone else.
But don't worry, nothing.
I've got that special shipment.
Get out there, get out there. Quick save. Who the hell? Damn it.
So, heard any word about the stolen supply?
I'm trying to pick her pockets. Got a small hunch that she's got the crate of supplies that I'm looking for. Oh, that quest.
She's gone, Father. Gone.
No, it looks like the stream's lagging. Pause. Apparently she didn't notice.
Like a madman.
Say again. What you said about my wife. Go on. Piss off. Go on, Sam.
Well, it's the truth, and you know it. She's better off. So what if it was messy? I'd rather puke myself to death 1,000 times.
Like he's got 1,000 lives or something.
I'd be happy for her.
A flat smile twitches across Balladeer's lips.
She never did like you.
Wow, that's a one-hit wonder. Free juice for me.
The man looks for a moment at the corpse at his feet, then turns back toward the nearly finished coffin, bloodied hammer in hand.
Murder's a big word. And no, this here's a bed for someone 1,000 times better than that snake. Talk about their soulmate like that. Maybe it is murder. Maybe not all killings as bad as arrest, though.
He nods at you and turns back to his handiwork.
See if I can yoink some stuff off of him. Hello?
The man looks for a moment at the corpse at his...
Okay, a sharp piece of metal. I think I can craft an item with that. Yep. Look at something. Okay. So then two of my skills are locked out. Okay, it doesn't say stolen, so. Take your leave. Alrighty, well, that's gonna do it for me. I'm gonna go ahead and shut her down. I gotta work tonight, so I'm gonna have to get ready for that eventually. Gotta type some stuff down on my blog post, and I need to get a nap in there as well. So, still got a fair amount to do today. But, so far, I'm liking it. The way it's looking now, though, I guess one downside, but I think it's something that probably brought on myself, is the combat is just next to impossible. I mean, it's like all the fights in here are like way overpowered to me, so it's due to me playing on Tactician. If they had an honor mode in one of the lower difficulty levels, I probably would have chosen that. But yeah, it's like you can only do honor mode on the highest difficulty level, and that's it. So, but yeah, otherwise, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that. And tomorrow, I'm beginning to think I might actually play another game. It's just, it's not that I'm burning out on this game, it's just I basically took up this game while I was still in the middle of Baldur's Gate, and hell, there's still a Planescape Torment that I was wanting to play as well, so, like I said, nothing official yet, but there's a chance I might actually switch to another game tomorrow, but otherwise, it's gonna be at the same time, probably around 4:30-ish, but until then, though, thanks again for coming, everybody, and see you all next time.